Yes.
Thank you. Please feel free to have a seat.
Mr. Fran, I'm going to stand back here just because I want to make sure that the end jurors are going to be able to hear you. But if you cannot hear me at any point in time, please just ask me to speak up and I'll be glad to do so, okay?
Okay.
All right. And Mr. Fran, since we're being recorded here today, would you please state your first and last name and spell your last name for the record?
Chris Frain, F-R-A-I-N.
And Mr. Frain, where do you currently live? What city?
Manchester.
How long have you lived in Manchester?
My whole life.
Life. Okay, and how old are you now?
40.
All right. So been here for 40 years?
Yes.
All right. What are some of the different kinds of jobs that you've had during your lifetime?
I've been a mechanic. I did waterproofing, and now I work for a highway department.
Highway department. And how far did you go in school?
A little bit of college.
Okay. And what was that for? What were you studying in college?
Automotive repair.
All right. Ian, have you ever been married?
Yes.
Okay. And what was your spouse's name?
Kim.
Kim. Same last name, Kim Frain?
Yes.
Are you still currently married?
No.
All right. When did the two of you split?
March of 20.
March of 2020? Back in 2019, what were you doing for work then?
I was working for Venture Construction.
Okay. And what type of construction work does Venture do?
Waterproofing, bridges and stuff like that.
What does that entail? What kind of, like, for your day-to-day, what does that look like when you were with them?
Usually the job site's at a different state, drive there, and if they want us to work for the week, we stay the week, or however it works out.
Okay. And you stay out there, you stay at the job site or a hotel nearby, I take it?
Yes.
All right. In September and October of 2019, did any of your jobs there take you to a place around Queensbury, New York?
Yes.
Right. What was the job?
We were putting high friction surface on a couple of bridge decks.
A couple of bridge decks? Is that the top of the deck or top of the bridge or the bottom of the bridge?
Yes, to the top.
Okay. And what was your normal work schedule back then? Where were you on any given day?
On the bridge.
Okay.
In Queensbury.
And how about, and that was a bad question for me, I apologize. What days were you working?
We would leave from home on Sunday and work Monday through Friday and come home after work.
When you were gone at work, while you were working on this this bridge, in Queensbury, New York, when you did that, who was living at home during the week? Who was at your home when you were not there?
Kim and my young daughter.
Okay. And did you have any firearms or any guns in the house?
Yes.
All right. What guns did you own in the home?
I have a HK-45 pistol. I had a Ruger LCP. I had an AR-15 and a 12-gauge shotgun.
12-gauge shotgun. Do you remember the brand of that shotgun?
Mossberg.
Mossberg. What color was it?
Black.
And did you have any attachments to that shotgun?
It had a scope on it.
Okay. So that's a scope for folks. Could you please explain for the jury what a scope is for people who might not be familiar with firearms?
It's like a mini telescope that you look through to help focus on the target.
Okay. And did it have, what are some of the other features of the shotgun? So for example, the grip or the stock that goes into your arm. Could you describe that for the jury?
It had a thumb hole buttstock. You could put your thumb through it and get a better grip.
And did it have any other sort of attachments on the side of it?
Not that I can recall.
Separate from that, do you recall whether it had the ability, how many rounds that it would hold?
I believe 4.
What kind of shotgun was this? Was this like one of the ones where you kind of pump it to fire one, or that's what it was?
Yes.
Okay. And you said that you also owned a AR-15.
Yes, correct? Stag Arms Model 2.
Stag Arms Model 2, that's the brand name, Stag Arms?
Yes.
Did that also have an optic on it or a sight on it?
Yes, a Romeo 7.
Romeo 7, okay. And finally, you said you had a Ruger firearm as well?
Yes.
Is that a long gun or is that a pistol?
Pistol.
Pistol. Where, I want to talk with you for a moment about the shotgun and the rifle. Where did you normally store those guns in your house?
They were under my bed, wrapped up in a blanket.
Wrapped up in a blanket?
Yes.
Okay. They were under your bed. How many bedrooms did you have in your house?
Four.
Four? Okay. And at the time, were you and Kim living in the same bedroom?
Yes.
How long had you owned the rifle?
Maybe a month. I just got it.
Where'd you get it from?
My youngest brother.
Youngest brother?
Yes.
And what's his name?
Connor.
Understanding with the defendant's agreement, I'd like to strike the state's identification on state's exhibit 6.
No objection?
No objection, Your Honor.
The ID is stricken on exhibit 6. It's entered as a full exhibit.
Mr. Frank, I'm showing you what's marked state's exhibit 6. Do you recognize that photo?
Yes.
Okay. How do you recognize it?
That's me holding my AR.
Okay. How long had you had the gun again?
Maybe a month.
Maybe a month or so? All right. And so this was taken, what, in that same frame, that same fall of 2019?
Yeah, that was the weekend before I had him stolen.
The weekend before it was stolen? Okay. Your Honor, permission to publish to the jury?
Yes, you may.
So this is taken just a week before this gun is stolen from you? Is that correct?
Yes.
And you said that it did have an optic that was attached to it. I believe you said a Romeo 7.
Yes.
Is that a brand name or is that a style? Or?
It's a model.
It's a model. Understanding with the defendants, no objection would be asked to be identity stricken on statement.
No objection, correct? The ID is stricken. Exhibit 33 is entered as a full exhibit.
Mr. Frank, you said that that was a Stag Arms Model 2. Correct?
Yes, correct.
And I'm going to show you now what's been marked State's Exhibit 33. Do you recognize that rifle?
Yes.
And with regards to this, what am I holding here from the rifle box?
A Sig Romeo 7.
Okay. Is that yours?
Yes.
So this was your rifle?
Yes.
Could you describe a little bit for the optic? You said that it was telescopic?
No, that is just an electronic red dot that helps you aim and focus on the target real quick.
The one for the shotgun, did it work the same way that this one works to be able to put a dot on something?
That was more telescopic.
That was more telescopic, okay. Was it bigger or smaller than this one?
Bigger.
Bigger. Permission to publish the rifle to the jury, Your Honor?
Yes,
just to demonstrate, I will leave it in the box.
Yes.
Friend, do you mind if I leave these here in front of you? Is that okay?
That's fine.
Thank you. When you went away for the week, Mr. Frank, on the week of September 29th, and you came back later that week, was that a full week of work or was it a short week?
Full week.
Full week? And when you came back, when did you realize that this was one, that this gun was stolen?
Shortly after I got home.
Shortly after you got home?
That night.
How did you find out it was stolen?
I went looking for them.
And could you explain to the jury, why did you go looking for them?
Because I was supposed to go target shooting with my brother the next day. I was going to clean them.
Okay. And you were going to clean them before going?
Correct.
Thank you very much for allowing me to use this space.
You're welcome.
What about your Mossberg shotgun? Was that there when you went looking for it as well that day?
No.
Don't have a shotgun to find to show you. Do you know if that shotgun was ever recovered?
I don't know.
You said that you had one of the other guns that we talked about a moment ago was the 380, the pistol that you said you had. Was that also kept under the bed in blankets?
No, that was kept in a drawer.
Kept in a drawer? In which room?
My bedroom.
And was that there when you went to look the day you came home?
It was not.
A lot of times people think about things being burglarized from them, and they think about what they see on TV. How did your house look when you got home? Were things...
It looked pretty much the way I left it.
Okay. Did you see any sign of a broken glass or a broken door?
No.
Anything else that, you know, people might think about when they think about a smash or a break-in or something like that?
Nothing.
Nothing like that. Did you discover that anything else was missing from the house?
Yeah, my watch and a few other miscellaneous things.
And later on, did you find out what happened to the watch and the other miscellaneous things?
No. I heard that Kim pawned some of it, but I don't know exactly what.
Okay. So, yeah, I just want to ask you about what you saw or what you know, not necessarily what you've heard.
Okay. I don't know.
Okay. All right. So... when did you call police after you discovered that these were missing?
I discovered it late at night, so I called the following morning.
And what number did you call for the police? 911 business
no.
line? Or?
I think I called the business line. It wasn't 911.
When the police officer came to your house, did he come that same day that you called?
Yes.
And did you share with them the details about what you knew about the guns, where you had last seen them, all of that sort of information?
Yes.
And did that include eventually making sure that they knew the serial number of your gun?
Yes.
Just a moment, please, Robert. I want to recap, Mr. Green, briefly. So with regards to that rifle and the black Mossberg shotgun, those two you found when you came back after a full week's worth of work?
Yes.
And did you ever find those two guns?
No.
In fact, until we looked at that there, when was the last time you saw that rifle?
When I shot it that day.
The week before they were missing?
Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Frayne. I have no further questions for you. I believe defense counsel may have a few.
Good morning, Mr. Frayne. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. I'm Robin Davis. So I just want to ask you a couple of follow-up questions to your testimony before the state this morning. So you indicated that back in 2019, you and your wife, Kim, and your daughter were all living in Manchester?
Correct.
On Russell Street?
Correct.
And as part of your work, you left your residence on September 29th. Is that correct?
Yes.
And that's a Sunday night?
Yes.
As you indicated, you leave on a Sunday and arrive on a Friday?
Correct.
So Monday, Tuesday, you were gone?
Correct.
And in fact, you returned on October 2nd, which was a Wednesday, correct?
I thought it was a Friday, but
okay,
it was 4 years ago.
We agree that Sunday was September 29th.
Okay, yes.
Okay, that's when you left.
Yes.
And then Monday would have been the 30th.
Yes.
October 1st would have been Tuesday.
Yes.
And then October 2nd, when you said you discovered the firearms were missing, that would have been a Wednesday.
Okay, yes.
All right. And you indicated that you had utilized those firearms at the range with a friend on September 28th.
Correct.
Okay. And so on September 28th, you knew that both of the long guns, the AR-15 and the shotgun, were in your home.
Yes.
And in fact, you returned them to their location under your bed.
Correct.
Wrapping them in blankets.
Yes.
And that's where you stored them.
Yes.
And you also checked the dresser drawer for the 380.
Yes.
And the 45.
Yes.
And those were also located in your bedroom.
Yes.
And they were in the same dresser drawer.
Yes.
And then you left on your trip, and when you returned on October 2nd, you again checked for those weapons, correct?
Yes.
You were going shooting again?
Yes.
And there were no weapons under your bed?
Correct.
Were the blankets there?
Yes.
The blankets were still under the bed?
They were.
Just empty?
Empty.
And you then checked your dresser drawer for the handguns?
Correct.
And one of the handguns, the 380, that was missing?
Yes.
But the 45 was still in the drawer?
Yes.
And that caused a little suspicion for you, didn't it?
Yes.
Because you were told that those firearms were stolen?
Yes.
And yet the person that may have stolen one of the handguns left the other?
Yes.
And that was curious to you, wasn't it?
Yes.
And what was the value of those guns? Do you know? I know that you bought them.
Correct.
And who did you buy them from?
The 45 I got from Shooter's Outpost. The Ruger I got from a friend of mine. The shotgun I got from another friend. And the rifle I got from my brother.
So three of them were private sales?
Yes.
Amongst individuals, and one was from Shooter's Outpost?
Correct.
And what was the value of the AR-15?
Somewhere around $800, I believe.
Okay. And how about the rifle?
A couple $100.
Okay. And how about the handguns?
Oh, the 45 was $1,000. The 380, I think I paid $150 for it.
Okay, so the 45 was actually the more expensive handgun, and that's the one that was left behind?
Yes.
Okay. And you've already indicated this, but these guns were just stored in your home. They weren't locked?
No.
And there was no safe?
No.
No safeguards on them?
No.
Okay. So anyone that was in the house could have located those guns?
Yes.
And you indicated to the police when you reported the guns missing that the only person that knew where they were was your wife, Kim?
Correct.
And at that time, Kim indicated to you that she knew nothing?
Correct.
and you had no knowledge that anyone else had been in the house?
No.
But you were still suspicious of Kim?
Yes.
And you knew that prior to this, items had been missing from your home?
Yes.
And money?
Yes.
And had you approached Kim about that?
Yes.
And did she indicate she had taken them?
Sustained.
And was she able to give you any information about them?
At first, no.
Okay. And you also knew that Kim was using drugs at that time?
Yes.
And you were concerned about that?
Yes.
And when you located or discovered that the firearms were missing, you also discovered that there were additional items missing?
Correct.
And you mentioned a watch?
Yes.
That was about $800?
Yes.
And your wedding ring?
Yes.
Okay. And you learned later that that had been pawned by Kim?
Yes.
And once you had reported it to the police in October, you didn't have contact with the police again until November, the next month.
Correct.
And at that time, they asked you if you had located the firearms.
Sustained.
They hadn't located the firearms at that point.
Right.
And they also indicated that the case was going to be closed.
I don't remember that.
Okay. Did you speak with the police again regarding the firearms?
Yes.
In 2019?
I don't remember.
Okay. Do you remember that your wife got arrested in 2019?
Yes.
And that was for drugs?
Yes.
And the next time you spoke with the police was February 14th of 2022, is that correct?
Yes.
And that was almost 2 years after your guns went missing?
Correct.
And on this date, you had learned that Kim had not been truthful with you?
Correct.
And the contact that you had with them in February 14th of 2022, they wanted to speak with you about the missing guns.
Yes.
And you indicated to them that you still didn't know who had the missing guns.
Correct.
And that wasn't true, was it?
No.
Because you had had contact with Adam Montgomery.
I did, yes.
And he indicated.
Sustained.
You had learned that Ishmael Garcia.
Sustained.
Had you learned?
Counsel, approach.
After you continued to speak with the police, you told them that you knew that Ish Garcia was the one that had the weapons.
No.
On February 14th?
I told them Adam told me that.
Yes.
But I didn't take it. I took it with a grain of salt.
So that didn't concern you?
Not coming from him.
Okay. But you never shared that information with the police, did you?
When I was interviewed, yes.
But before that, the conversation happened before that, a year
right.
before that.
I did not. You're right.
So the conversation happened a year before.
Yes.
You had this interview with the police.
Yes.
And you did not share that information at that time with the police.
I did not.
And it wasn't until they wanted to talk to you a year later in 2022 that you shared that information.
Yes.
And you told them the reason you didn't share that information, didn't you?
Yes.
And that information, you didn't share that information because you were actually scared of the person.
Yes.
You had met Ishmael Garcia?
Yes.
And that was not a pleasant interaction, was it?
No.
And you weren't looking forward to having a second interaction with him?
No.
And in fact, the word you used with the police was that you were scared of him.
Yes.
I have nothing further. Thank you.
You can stay where you are.
Thank you, Your Honor. Just, friends, just a couple quick follow-up questions to what you were just asked a moment ago. I think that there's maybe a little bit of confusion that I have, but I want to make sure that it's clear. You testified on direct examination that you had worked a full week when you were gone out for that Queensbury job that week. And a moment ago, it sounded like you were saying you were back on Wednesday, October 2nd.
Yeah, I don't remember exactly what day and time I got home.
Let me just ask, generally, without knowing a specific day, do you feel like it would work a full week or that it had been less than a full week? And if you don't know, you don't know.
I don't know.
Okay, thank you. Next question that I have for you is that you said that when you looked back underneath the bed, that some of the blankets there were still there.
Yes.
Were all of the blankets there or just some of the blankets there?
No, it was only two and they were both there.
You were asked a moment ago by counsel whether or not at one point you were suspicious of your wife Kim on taking these two long guns.
Yes.
Are you still suspicious of Kim taking the long guns now?
No.
And you were also asked a moment ago about having conversations with Adam Montgomery. Is he in the courtroom here today?
Yes.
Where is he seated? Can you point him out and describe what he's wearing for us?
He's wearing a white shirt.
The record shall so reflect.
Thank you. You said when he told you about where the long guns had gone, I believe you testified a moment ago that you took down from the grain of salt.
Yes, and not the long guns, the 380.
The 380, but you took it with a grain of salt.
Yes.
Thank you. No further questions.
Mr. Frayne, you reported the missing guns on October 3rd. Do you remember that now?
Yes.
Okay. Because there was a police report generated,
yes.
Correct? And did you get a copy of that police report?
Yes.
Okay. So if it says October 3rd, that would be the correct date?
Yes.
2019?
Yes.
And therefore, you had discovered the weapons missing on October 2nd?
Correct.
And it was late at night, so you waited to call the police?
Yes.
And the state had asked if you were suspicious that Kim took the guns, and you indicated you're not now.
No.
Were you suspicious that she knew who took the guns?
Yes.
And she may have been aware when the guns were taken?
Yes.
Thank you.
All set, Your Honor. We would ask this witness to be excused, please.
You may step down. Any objection to his being excused? May be excused. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's 10:35, so we're 10:37.
So is this a good time to take our mid-morning break? So we'll take a 15-minute break, and then we will be back to resume testimony. All rise for the jurors, please. Council, approach for just 1 minute.